Hey everyone, the Game Piece here. Welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be going over how the Dojo Leader rematches work in Temtem. This was added as part of the most recent patch update. You're going to be able to go back and re-challenge old Dojo Leaders that you've already defeated and be able to obtain rewards for doing so. So let's get right into what you need to know. So once you get back into the game, as of the most recent patch update, you can go back and challenge these Dojo Leaders. The important thing to note first and foremost though is you will need a competitive squad. These battles will not be any casual matches. You'll have to go through the pick and ban phase and choose a competitive squad that you want to use in this battle. Go to a Temporium and go to the Tem deck and change out your competitive squad into the squad that you feel is suitable for the Dojo Leader that you want to challenge. These leaders will have full teams of level 58. They will be TV trained and it looks like they have gear items on them as well. So it's not going to be an easy fight. You're going to have to plan a little bit. You will not also be able to use items in these fight whatsoever. So make sure you're bringing a squad that is sustainable and capable of getting the job done. Because you won't be able to use any healing items, meaning you won't be able to use any revives, any balms, any of that stuff. So make sure you are well prepared beforehand. So once you have that team ready to rock and placed in the competitive squad, all you have to do is make your way over to the dojo, make your way through the puzzle again, and then talk to the leader and you'll be initiated into a challenge. Like I said though, this is a competitive battle, so you will have to go through the pick and ban phase, so make sure that you're picking and banning the appropriate choices for your squad, and they also will be able to pick and ban options as well, so make sure you're bringing enough options to be able to deal with any sort of threats that the dojo leader has. I know I've only done Sophia so far, but the dojo fight was not easy. It was definitely not a pushover, so make sure you are coming prepared like I said. I definitely had to think about this one. But once you manage to defeat the dojo leader, the first three leaders that you defeat each week will grant you a reward of a radar item. Now these items can be used to chain particular Temtem. We'll have a more in-depth video going over that, but you can get three of these per week for defeating these dojo leaders. You also get a monetary reward in the form of Pan Sun for defeating Sophia. Here I roughly got 7,000 Pan Sun. So if you go ahead and defeat all the leaders, there's four of them that you can defeat each week. And you will be able to get that same monetary reward, I believe, for each single one. So you're looking at about 30,000 Pan Sun per week just for defeating these leaders, which is pretty respectable, pretty nice to have just for an extra thing for us to do each week. But let me know what you guys think of these Dojo Leader rematches. Are you guys for them or against them? I definitely am for them. They're really cool to see. And I do think it's really extremely cool how they have implemented the competitive format in these fights as well. And just utilize the pick and ban features and everything like that. It's really cool to see and really cool to see them take advantage of that as well. But let me know what you guys think in the comments below, and hopefully you guys are enjoying the new patch. Please feel free to subscribe and leave a like. There will be more content videos on the way very shortly for Temtem, but hopefully you guys are all enjoying the patch. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I hope you guys have a fantastic rest of your day.